My name is Sunidhi Ved and I'm from Regional Institute of Education, Ajmer, pursuing B.Ed. And I'm here in HKH Public School for my internship program. And today I'm going to teach 7th class students English, where I'll be talking to them about a nature lover girl who has immense love for flowers, especially trilliums. Morning class, please sit down.
Thank you, ma'am.
How are you all?
I'm fine.
Fine. Okay. So today we will talk about an interesting thing. Do you all love flowers?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So why do you love them? One by one. Why do you love them? Yes.
Because they are beautiful. Okay. They are beautiful. Next.
Their smell is good.
They smell, their smell is good. Okay, they have a good fragrance. Anyone else? Yes, Udit.
I love nature and they are the part of nature.
Alright, so flowers, they make our surroundings look beautiful and very colorful. Alright, so do you have any memory related to a flower? Yes.
I go to the garden near my home. There was a flower like rose and they smell very good. And their colouring are very beautiful.
Okay, which flower? Can you name that flower?
Some
rose. Rose. Okay. Any other? Yes?
Ma'am, I have a memory with flowers. I went for a vacation in Munnar and in a park I saw roses, orange rose, purple rose and many flowers.
Okay, you went for your vacations and you saw different types of flowers. Okay, alright. So, just like you have memory related to a flower, so similarly, we are going to study a chapter where there is a girl and she too has a memory related to a flower and she shares it. So, we will be studying about it. We will read about it in the chapter and the name of the chapter is Tiptoe Through the Trilliums. What do you mean by tiptoe? Tiptoe means to walk quietly and trilliums are flowers. I'll show you the image of the flower. These are trilliums. They are three-petaled flowers and they are found basically in North America and in parts of Asia. Alright? They are rare flowers. Now we'll start the chapter. First time reading it. Okay? Please listen very carefully. The trilliums are back. My young daughter has flung the front door open with her announcement. But she doesn't enter knowing better. Her rubber boots are filthy, covered in mud from playing outside on our small forested area. The huge muddy nose of her very large and wet companion, Saint Bernard, peeps around her legs, hoping for an invitation to visit. Muddy feet on carpet don't bother him at all. Unfortunately, they do bother me. Now, who will read it again? Udit, please read.
The trilliums are back. My young daughter has flung the front door open with the announcement. But she doesn't enter. Knowing better, her rubber boots are filthy, covered in mud from playing outside on our small forested area. The huge muddy nose of her very large and very wet companion, Saint Bernard, peeps around her legs. Hoping for an invitation to visit. Muddy feet on carpet don't bother him at all. Unfortunately, they do bother me. Really, the trilliums are respond from the safety of my mud-free zone. Yes, they are back. I can tell she excited and wants me to come and take a look. It's raining through. I will be up to my ankles in mud.
Okay, hold on.
Ujjwal, please pronounce this word again.
Filthy.
Filthy. The word pronunciation for this word is?
Filthy. Filthy.
Alright. And this word. What is it?
Mambuti.
Bother. Theek hai? This chapter, it basically tells us about that we should love nature. And then in the end, it will give us a message that how we as human beings, in order to fulfill our selfish needs, in order to fulfill our desires, how we have destroyed nature. Okay, so this is the essence of the chapter. This is the gist of the chapter. Now, the story starts with a girl. The girl who is sharing her memory related to flower. So she comes and she is all excited. Okay, she comes and tells the trilliums are back. And to whom does she tell?
His mother.
Very good. His mother. Now, she in excitement, she flung the door open. Flung means to open something with force. So with full force, she opens the door. Okay, and with full excitement, she tells her mother that the trilliums are back. But she doesn't enter knowing better. Now, why she doesn't enter? Because, yes.
Because she better know their rubber boots are filthy, filthy covered with mud. So they do not dirty the home. So they do not dirty the home and they don't coming in the home.
Okay, very good. Sit down. She does not enter the house. She is just standing at the threshold of the house. Why she does not enter? Because she know that her rubber boots are filthy. Because she has been playing outside a small forested area near their house. So her rubber boots have become dirty with mud. Alright. So her rubber boots are dirty. And there is a companion. Who is the companion, beta?
Saint Bernard.
Very good. Saint Bernard. Very good. Please sit down. So he, there is a dog and he is a companion. And the name is Saint Bernard. The name is not Saint Bernard. It is a breed of a dog. Breed is a variety. Dogs are also of different varieties.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
You must have seen a Labrador, a Dachshund. So Saint Bernard is also a type of a breed. Okay. I'll show you. This is Saint Bernard. Can you see it at the back?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So now the dog is waiting for an invitation. The dog is also all soiled with mud. Okay. Because he has also been playing outside. And it's raining, so the dog is wet. Alright, so he is waiting for the invitation that the mother would signal him and he would then come in. But the muddy carpet won't bother him. It is not going to bother the dog, but definitely it is going to bother the mother. Why? Because she would have to sweep the whole house again. Alright, have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so next, please read.
Yes, they are back. I can't tell. She is excited and wants me to come and take a look. It's ringing though. I will be up to my ankles in mud. Yes, yet I decided if my daughter and the dog don't mind it, why should I? After all, when is she not ringing around here? Especially this time of the year. So I pull on my own rubber boots and off we go.
The mother, she asks her daughter again to confirm if the statement she had said is true or not. Then the child say that yes, the trilliums are back. The mother can make out from her excitement that she wants her to accompany her and go out to the nearby forest area and explore the beauty of the flowers. Now the mother, she's thinking that if she goes out, she will also get dirty. She will also be up, the mud would be up to her ankles. Okay, but then she thinks, she had a second thought that if the girl is not minding, if my daughter is not minding going out, and if the dog is also not minding, then why should I? So then she decides to go out. Alright, please read. Now, what is the meaning of this word? Boggy. Yes. Okay, something which is wet. Or you can say a land which is marshy, spongy, marshy. We say daldal in Hindi. Okay, kichar. Okay, so the land is marshy. Why? Because it's been raining in the forest. So now, while they are walking in the forest area, so on both sides of the path, there are trees. And the branches of the trees, they are so wide, they are so large that they are forming a protective shield. Okay, the branches, they are intertwined and they are forming a protective shield. Alright. Now, as we approach an ancient fir garden of the trail, my daughter slows back and holds back her hand, signaling the expedition to halt. What is the meaning of the word approach?
Ma'am, come near.
Very good. Approach means to come near. So when they came near an ancient fir, fir is basically a coniferous trees, and coniferous trees have leaves that are needle shaped. Okay, they have needle shaped leaves. Okay, so when they approach this fir tree, the girl, she holds back. Okay, she stops and she signals the mother as well as Saint Bernard, the dog. Okay, and she asks them also to stop and their expedition. Expedition means, what is the meaning of expedition? Yes, Mohit?
A journey undertaken by a group of people with a deafness.
Okay, simply stated, expedition means a journey. Okay, so their journey, it comes to a halt. Halt is a break, a short pause. Okay, so the journey, it comes to a halt. The girl, she signaled her mother. All the three, they stop. Why they stop? Because the girl had seen the trillium and she wants them to have a good look at those flowers. Okay, or what she thinks, that if they make any more noise, the trilliums, they would get startled, they would get frightened and they would run away. So this is what she basically thinks. Now here, the characteristics of the flower, trillium, has been described. Now the first characteristics is, can anyone tell? Yes.
Ma'am, when they are picked, they don't grow back.
Okay, when they are picked, if you pluck the flowers, they will not grow back. Okay, so this is the first characteristics. Second,
ma'am.
Yes, Ujwal.
They don't bloom.
Okay, they don't bloom for a long period of time. The first characteristics is that they don't bloom for a long period of time. Okay, they don't grow in large numbers unlike the other flowers. Okay, the other spring flowers. Thirdly, you cannot buy them in stores. As I've already told you, these are rare flowers. So you cannot easily buy them in stores. And the fourth point is that if you pluck them, they won't grow back. Okay, so we end this chapter here. You will be putting up this question to team B. Okay, you select anyone you want to, and that person would be answering your question. All right, and the person to whom the answer had been asked, you would in turn ask the question to team A.
Why is the girl excited?
Why is the girl excited? Mohit, please stand up.
The girl was excited because the trilliums grow back, so you are very excited.
Okay, very good. Please sit down. The girl was excited because the trilliums are back. The trilliums were back. Next. These were the questions related to grammar and the chapter, the content part. Now we will be doing another activity, okay? There is this puzzle. There is a proper word written among these words. All right? Synonym for the word journey. First, tell the class what is the synonym for the word. Please come out. Okay, good try.
Expedition.
Very good. Expedition. Where is the word? Very good. Expedition. Okay, synonym for dirty. First tell what is the synonym for the word dirty.
Filthy.
Okay, where is the word? Now, tomorrow we will be continuing the chapter, okay, and we would see how she describes her present condition, okay. The present condition of the girl, where she is longing for the trilliums, because the trilliums, they are now no more, because the nature has been destroyed. Alright? So I hope you enjoyed today's class.
Yes.
Okay? Have a nice day.